It was the that got me. It was the break. Deflate, because I was gassed. Head over heels in love with the electric drums and spoken vocals, which was the joke of locals and laughing stock of my rock and roll ass town. But the rhythmic acupuncture pierced my skin, pinning the butterflies to my stomach, which would flutter every time I heard the boom, more than the. I was no devil worshiper! Higher level interpreter. I refuse to lose. Focus and recite satanic verses with many curses. Drug-induced worst was I knew they were saying, kill your mother, because it paid them well. Yet in my flashback, I see the foreshadow. Ironic twist, my first purchase was a hip-hop record called Raising Hell. I should have run when I had the chance, but DMCs made me want to break dance, made me want to spin vinyl, made me want to graph right, made me want to not act white. And not to perpetuate any stereotype, but I was not about the mullet ice hockey haircut. You know the mullet. Short on top for the fellas, long and back for the ladies, yeah. I was not about the stonewashed nut huggies with the French rolls on the bottom so tight it turned my toes purple. No, I was about the ripped jean jacket with the Megadeth Metallica and Slayer patch. I had an internal itch for the and never could I get with the guitar riff. I had wild style wars. I rented Beat Street every week as I rocked steady, wearing out the player rewinded slow-mo buttons on my VCR. I did the pause play all day, forced my way into comprehension of inner city invention. For me, it was in the expression, which would eventually win me exception. One exception. Those around me couldn't give me affection, but I played and paid that video attention until eventually I completely bit the and found my new religion. Born again, B-boy. Born to destroy decoys and be the real McCoy. Yeah, boy! I wore the clock so you could know the time! Chuck D told me to keep a sober mind. And even though his sidekick liked the flavor of bass, I swore to God hip-hop was about being drug-free. I swore to God hip-hop was about the upliftment of humanity. And I swore to God hip-hop was what rock was not, was what rock was not pop. Guess I was gassed. See, I remember when Dr. Dre used to express himself about hitting the chronic. A few years later, he's endorsing it while drinking gin and tonic. Suburbanites that blast mace learn their mad face from Onyx. It was a rat race, the first to properly use Ebonics. Dynamite like JJ, but it was a fad like supersonic. Hip hop flipped from being artistic to a pop hit. Mainstream took control and we cannot stop it. It's a black art being manipulated by white control is just like rock and roll is. We took the